In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how to use Lightroom if you are a complete beginner. I'm going to show you all the basic features you need to know how to use if you want to edit professional quality photos. So without any further ado, let's jump straight into my computer and get into the program. So when you first open up Lightroom, this is kind of what you are going to be greeted with. And you know, it might seem a little confusing at first. So let's start off by how to import some pictures. So, you know, you went out to the field, you took some awesome banger shots, and now you want to edit them. So how do you actually do that? Well, so once you're here, you will need to click on this little import button, and there you will be able to select your source from where you want to, you know, import the photos from. So in this example, I'm going to just import some photos from my desktop. And as you can see, I have three photos here. And the cool thing is, you know, if you have a ton of photos on your SD card or something, you know, you can just go through them here by clicking the arrows, and you have these two views. You have the gallery view and you have the single image view. And you know, the way you include the photos that you want to edit is by checking this little box here, or if you are in the full photo view, then you just click include in import, right? So once you have selected the images that you want to edit, and you know, you can find them from here. If you have an SD card, then you will be just able to see that here as well. Once you have selected the ones that you want to import, you will go and click import here in the bottom right corner, right? So once you did that, it's going to import the photos into Lightroom so you can actually start working on them. So a cool quick little tip that I have for you guys is, if you have a lot of pictures and you only want to, you know, you edit the best ones, what you can do is you can press 1 to 5 on your keyboard on every single photo and give them a rating. So when you're editing a lot of images, you will be able to see which ones you rated as a 5-star one, which ones you rated as a 2-star, 3-star, and so on. So as you can see on the top part of the program, we have all these different buttons. And, you know, the library is the place where you will be able to see all the photos that are in your Lightroom currently. You will be seeing this catalog little thing here. And if you click on all photos, then you see all the photos that you have ever imported into Lightroom. And if you go into previous import, you can see the last ones you imported. And if you have Adobe Cloud and you have photos online, you can also see your synced photographs here. Other than that, these are all, you know, stuff here that you are not going to use a ton. So I'm not going to go deep into that, because in this video, I really just want to focus on the things that you're going to use on a day-to-day basis. So as you can see, this is the library part. And then the other very important part of Lightroom that you're going to be using all the time is the develop tab. So this is where you can actually edit your photos, and the map, book, slideshow, print, and web section is something you're not going to use a lot. So I'm not going to go deep into that. Basically, none of these are necessary for your photo editing, unless you want to, you know, do stuff like printing and, you know, that kind of things. But I'm not going to go deep into that. How do you actually get started editing here, right? So first of all, just to walk you through quickly, the develop tab, right here on the left side, we have your presets, and you can also see the snapshots and history, you know, thing here. Basically, in the history tab, you can go back and forth between your edits that you make to your picture as you're editing them. So if you ever want to undo something or redo something, you can do that in the history tab really easily, right? You can also create collections of photos there and snapshots. To be honest, I'm not even entirely sure what that is, because, you know, I never use that. Here you can zoom into your image and you know, see more details there, or you can select one of their like preset fits or zooms, and you can also just click fit if you want to see the whole image, right? Now here at the presets, if you want to add your own presets, maybe you bought some from some influencer or you created your own, you can add them by clicking on this add new presets button and then import your presets there. Or you can also create your own preset from by clicking this. Then you can save all the different settings that you you know, selected in a certain photo as a preset, so you can apply those same settings and adjustments that you made to that picture to other pictures as well by just clicking one button. So that's a really, really useful, you know, feature as well. So as for the presets, you can see that Adobe has a lot of built-in presets as well for, you know, touching up portraits or even coloring your photos. And you can preview them by just, you know, hovering your mouse over it. And if you want to apply one of them, let's say I want to apply this matte color preset, then I just click on it. And as you can see here in the editing part, it already applied these different settings on my picture. Now, if you ever want to reset your picture and the edits that you made to it, you can just click this reset button. And as you can see, it redid the editing that I've done to it. So let me show you how all these different things work in the editing panel. So this first thing is the crop tool. Here you can crop your image to whatever, you know, aspect ratio or whatever kind of crop you want. Here you can select from different aspect ratio templates or create your own custom aspect ratio as well. And you can also edit the angle here. And a really cool feature is that it has this auto angle feature that you can just click and it's going to automatically level out the image for you. We have a bunch of other different editing tools here as well. This one is basically the spot like healing tool or something like that. You can remove things from your image with it. So let's say I wanted to remove this duck right here. Then I can just, you know, click on that. I can create my own brush size, the amount of feather I want on it. And feather is basically just like how soft the edges are of the brush and also the opacity of it. And if I wanted to, you know, get rid of this, I can just press on this. It's going to find part of the image that would fit there. And as you can see, it fills it out for you. So I just got basically rid of that duck. As you can see, there is a little bit of residue from the duck, so I can just make that a bit bigger and boom, it's gone. Or if I wanted to get rid of this little, you know, red flare here, I just click on it and boom, it got rid of it and it seems quite seamless. So it is a great tool for removing you know, stuff like wrinkles or pimples or anything like that from faces, or you know, even something distracting from your background. This tool is the red eye tool. You can, you know, if the photo that you took has a red eye for either a pet or a person, you can get rid of it by using this tool. Now this is the mask or like gradient mask tool. And with this, you can basically, you know, create a gradient, which is pretty cool because, you know, let's say I wanted to make this part of my image only darker, then I can just, you know, pull down the exposure on it. And you can see, I can adjust this as I want. So if I wanted to create something like this, I can do that. And I can also edit a bunch of other things on it, not just the exposure, but, you know, I can edit the clarity, I can edit temperature if I wanted to add some more blue to this image, for example. You know, a lot of different ways to work with this tool. It is something, again, that is great for creating more contrast kind of in your edits, or just to make them more interesting by manipulating the lighting a bit, or even the colors or anything like that, right? Like Lightroom is a really creative tool, and you can do a lot, you know, with your image with it. So I think it's great. For example, here on this picture, the way I might use this is I would like to add some more light to here and make it a bit, you know, more warm, like the sun is almost like coming from there. I will make it a bit softer, right? And add some more dehaze to it. As you can see, I created this almost like light leak like effect, and I might add like a little bit more darkness to this part of the image to, you know, add some more contrast to it. I might make that a bit cooler looking, darker. I might add some more clarity to it, some less exposure, and you know, you can see how I already added like a little bit of extra flair to this image. So I'm going to show you how you can see the original picture and the edit. So here you can see the, you have these views here. This one, for example, You can choose a reference photo that you want to drag there. So this is good if you want to match, for example, the colors of another edit so you can see them side by side. And this one is the before and after view. So you can see how I added a bit more, you know, sun flare here and a bit more darkness on this side. And you can have different views on this one as well, like change which one is the before, which one is the after. You can have them on one image. And even like this. So, you know, quite a lot of options there. And this is again just a single view. The next tool we have in here is this circular mask tool. So you can basically, you know, create a circle or anything or an oval or anything like that and create a mask with it. And you can do all sorts of manipulations to the image with that. And you know, that is also pretty cool if you want to highlight a person or something and add more like spotlight on them. As you can see right now with this one that I created, it's editing everything outside of the mask. And you can also go and click on this invert button, and then it's only going to be editing what's inside the mask. So that is that tool, great for making faces brighter, for example, or you know, really highlighting something out of the background. The next tool here is the brush tool. So with this, you can basically, you know, set your settings as with all the other type of you know, editing tools. And let's say I wanted to make the image a bit more brighter at some places. Let's say I wanted to make, you know, this person brighter here. I can just brush over him. And as you can see, I'm creating basically a mask wherever I'm brushing right now. And now I can edit the exposure in just that part of the image, which is really cool, you know, and not only the exposure, but also like the color temperature of the image there, the shadows, you know, basically everything there is to adjust on a picture. Now I'm gonna go over all the adjustment tools and what every single one of them does, kind of, at least the ones that I use a lot, because, you know, I'm not claiming to be some sort of photo editing expert. It's just a hobby of mine and I enjoying it, but I'm not claiming that I'm like the best editor out there. I just wanted to share you know, my current knowledge with you guys, who, because a lot of you might also be beginners, so I really hope that this video can help some of you out. So as you can see, this is the basic editing tab here. Here you can adjust the color temperature of the image. So, you know, if you shot the photo in RAW with your camera, then you will be able to set the color like white balance afterwards, which is really cool. And you can also, you know, kind of have it auto set by picking like a white color, a white part of a picture, and then it's going to set it for you accordingly. But, you know, I like to kind of manually adjust this and make it look how I want it to. You can also add a tint to the picture. So if you want it to be, you know, greener, you would, you know, pull this way, or if you want it to be more magenta or pink, you would put it that way. I don't use that a lot, to be honest, but there is that option there as well. You can also adjust the exposure here with this slider. You can adjust the contrast with this slider. If you want Lightroom to do it for you, you can also adjust the highlights here manually. You can also, you know, adjust the shadows here, do whites of the image, the blacks, and you can create your contrast yourself as well. Bring down the shadows a bit and bring up the highlights a bit. That's one way to create some more contrast on your image. Then here we have texture. As you can see, this is just going to make your image look like a bit sharper and more kind of like, you know, detailed. And then we have clarity here, which does something pretty similar to it. Now, clarity is a great thing that I like to use on a lot of my pictures because I feel like it adds like that little extra punch to it. But it's really easy to go overboard with it. So, you know, don't use it too much. don't abuse clarity, I suggest. but you know, you can do whatever you want. Like, there's no rules to editing, you know, so there's that. Then we have dehaze, and this is, honestly, I'm not entirely sure what dehaze does, but you can see it can make the image look a bit softer if you put it, if you pull it into the negative, and make it look, I guess, a bit more contrasty if you put it in the right way. Then we have vibrance here, which, you know, you can use to adjust the vibrance of the image, and you also have saturation, which adjusts the saturation. So as you can see, this is the basic editing tab. A lot of these tools are going to be very useful for you and are great for, you know, creating a basic edit on your images. Then we have the tone curve here, which is basically where you can adjust, well, you know, either your red, green and blue channels manually on a tone curve, or you can use this where it has all the channels. And one thing I like to do a lot to add some more contrast to my images is to bring down the darks here a bit, the shadows, and bring up the highlights. You know, that's one very quick and easy way to add some more contrast to your image. It's called an S-curve, and you know, a lot of photographers and creative people use this. This is probably my worst S-curve that I've created so far, but I'm just trying to, you know, demonstrate how this works. And you can adjust the colors of the shadows and highlights individually on the different color channels as well by clicking on these. So that's the tone curve. Now the next tab is HSL and color. Now this is one that I love to use. Here you can basically adjust the hue, saturation and luminance of all the different colors manually. And you can also, you know, do it here. So let's say I wanted to make the greens more yellow. I can just pull it this way and you can see it just completely transformed the image. But one thing I can also do, if I want to select like a very specific color that I want to change either the hue, the saturation or luminance of, is I click on this and then I just grab one part of the image, and now I can adjust that alone by, you know, using my mouse or keyboard or trackpad to, you know, pull it up or down. And you can see this is pretty fun because you can change the, you know, look of the whole image really, really easily. You can also change the saturation of different colors. So let's say I wanted to get rid of this guy's, you know, blue sweater. I would just, you know, hit this, click on that and bring down the saturation on it, and boom, kind of took out that cyan and bluish color out of the image. So that is the HSL and color tab. It's something that's really useful to use if you want your images to be a little bit more special, and maybe you want to create that kind of like travel photo vibe where you desaturate some of the greens or anything like that, to be honest. Your imagination is the only limit. You have this color grading tab here where you can do something really similar to the other ones. Here you can adjust the midtones, the shadows and highlights as well. So if I wanted to add, let's say, some more blue to the shadows, I could just grab this and move it in the blue, you know, side a bit. So you can see I just added a bit more blue to the shadows, like the backpack and this part of the image as well. So it is also quite a cool, you know, tool. I don't use it a lot personally, but you know, if you want to play around with that, I think it's really fun as well. Now we have detail here, and this is again a really useful tool. I mean, a lot of these are useful, to be honest, so I'm gonna stop saying that, but you can see here you have sharpening. So if you want to make your image a bit like sharper looking, you can do that. You don't want to overdo it because it can look pretty bad sometimes, but you know, it's really useful sometimes. This is actually pretty cool how we can see the water drops on this picture. So you can see as I'm sharpening it, it makes it, you know, just look a bit sharper, but again, it can create kind of like an unpleasant look as well, so be very careful with that. And here you can also add some noise reduction to it. So let's say if your image is very noisy in the shadows, I mean, this image isn't because I shot it at a low ISO, but if it was, I could just go on here and add some noise reduction to it, and it would improve the image quite a lot. Now the next part is lens corrections. I always like to tick remove chromatic aberration. Chromatic aberration is basically when you see that little, you know, red and blue and color shift in the edge of some items or things on the side of your photos. You know, this happens because of the way I think the sun hits some lenses, or just in general, like if you don't have a super high quality lens, it can happen quite a lot. So that is something awesome, because Lightroom is able to detect chromatic aberration and get rid of it pretty well. So that's something I always check. And if you want to kind of like fix the distortion of your lens to make it look more like, you know, what it was in real life, you can click this enable profile corrections. And you can choose your lens, you know, brand and the exact lens that you shot the image with, and you can see it will, you know, correct it for you. So it will get rid of the vignetting of the lens and also the distortion that it creates. I personally quite like the vignetting on this one, and I like the original like distorted look a bit more, so I'm not gonna click that, but you know, it is really useful. And you can, if your lens is not on this list, then you can also do it manually right here. Now here we have the transform tab, where you can make all sorts of different adjustments to your image. So you can, you know, stretch it or make different adjustments to it and transform it in all sorts of ways. Obviously, I'm not doing too much good for this picture right now, but you know, feel free to play around with that and you know, experience that yourself. Not something I use a whole lot, so I'm not gonna go too deep into it because I'm not an expert at using that tool, to be honest. Now we have effects here. I like to use vignetting quite a lot. I think it creates like a really nice look. So here you can add post crop vignetting, and you can see how you can really make the viewer focus on the middle of the image a lot more if you use a vignette. You know, you don't want to go overboard with it because this looks like quite shit, but you know, I think just a little bit of it is quite nice. Actually, you can change the midpoint, the roundness of the vignette, create different shapes with it, the feather amount, right? Overall, I use vignetting quite a lot. And you can also add grain to your image if you want to create maybe like a older film look, if that's your thing. And lastly, we have calibration here, and you can set, you know, your green primary, your hue saturation, for all the different, you know, primary colors. To be honest, I'm not entirely an expert at that one either, so I'm not going to go deep into that, but I know you can affect the way the image looks quite drastically by, you know, playing around with this tab as well. So these are like the main tools that you will use in Lightroom. I personally like to use presets a lot, so I usually, the way I do my editing is I just you know, select the image I want to edit, I will look over my different presets and choose one that I like, and then make more edits to that. I'm not a huge fan of spending like hours on editing just one picture alone, but you know, it's good to learn how to use all these different tools, at least to a basic level, so you can really have full creative freedom when you're creating your images. Quick reminder to fuel yourself and hydrate yourself. So another cool feature that I want to show you guys that can save you a lot of time is if you go into the library tab, you can actually copy and paste the same adjustments you made to one picture to another by first of all selecting the image that you want to, you know, copy the adjustments from and paste them to another picture, and then you press shift and then select the image or images that you want to copy it to, and then you go and click sync settings, and here you can check or uncheck all the different settings that you want to have pasted to your other picture. You just click synchronize, and boom, all these different changes have been applied to this image as well. And this can save you a ton of time when you have a bunch of photos that look really similar and maybe were even taken at the same time, because then you can just really edit one of them and then just copy and paste those same settings to the other images as well. How do you actually export your images? Well, the first thing you need to do is select the images here that you want to export. In this case, I'm going to select all of them by pressing shift and then, you know, pressing on the last image, and then I'm going to go to file and then export, and now you can select where you want to export it to. I want to export it to my hard drive. In this case, I want to export it to my desktop. If you export multiple photos, it's going to create a subfolder for you, but you can also uncheck this. But I like to create a new folder whenever I export some photos. So I'm gonna just, you know, say tutorial for this folder name. And then basically after this, you can, you know, select your file naming here. You can select your photo format, the quality that you want to have on it, the sizing that you want to have on the photos, and a bunch of different things. But I usually just like to export them in full size and full quality. And, you know, I usually just post to social media, so it's going to dumb it down for me anyways. Now, if we go on my desktop, you can see that I have the exported photos right here in amazing high quality with all the pretty shitty edits I put on them. Now, I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please drop a like on it. And if you want to get Adobe Creative Cloud and get either a student discount on it, or, you know, just start your free 7-day trial to see whether you like it or not, I'm going to leave a link in the description below where you can check it. If you purchase it through that, you can support the channel because I get a small affiliate commission from it. Now, I'm not sponsored by Adobe or anything. I just genuinely like their softwares a lot. And I wanted to, you know, give you a little bit of that small amount of knowledge I have on it. So I will see you in the next one.